Oh, hi, Mark.
Oh, hi, Mark. I did not hit her.
We make that joke because Mark was actually the one that introduced me to the room. Like, he saw it way before anyone else made fun of it. And that was, he showed me the scene, and that it's like, now it's like the end joke between him and I. And nobody knows what the fuck we're talking about.
I need to show my older brother that, because his name is Mark as well.
Hello, everybody. How are you?
And then I say hi to her.
Oh, hi, Henry. Anyway, sound check, 212. You know how this works, ladies and gentlemen. I realize I'm parked outside a place I wasn't parked outside before at the end of Session 13 of Final Fantasy VII Live, but this is Session 14 of Final Fantasy VII Live. So who likes chocobo fucking? You know, I'm just gonna say it out there right now. I mean, Nathan?
Bird fucking!
Oh, yeah. I mean, this is shit you can't get on your local Google image searching.
No, you go to Rule 34 for that.
Yeah. Alright, did you say room 34? Anyway, this is... I'm not going to beat around the bush. This is a part of the game I don't like. I don't like chocobo breeding, chocobo racing, chocobo catching, anything chocobos, except when you have to catch it mandatory just for one time to get past the snake, which I did manage to beat in Disc 1. Pretty proud of that. But,
Yeah, it's time for that part.
Well, anyway, we should do some sound tests just to make sure everyone can hear us. So, my secret word of the day is falafel. Yeah, try and spell that. But, Nathan, you got a secret word?
Mnemonic. Yeah. What up, John?
Son of a bitch. Okay, let me just check everything here.
Falafel.
Close enough.
Falafel. Oh, hey, Ryan spelled it.
Falafel. Someone said falafel. Pwaffle, falafel, panini. Someone said taco. It's all good. Okay. Yes.
New monarch.
Okay, here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Session 14 of Final Fantasy VII Live. Nothing but the Chocobos today, ladies and gentlemen. We're parked outside the Chocobo Ranch. We haven't been here since Disc 1. I remind you that we're at the tail end of Disc 2. Oh, all the Chocobos that were in here are gone. They can't dance for me anymore. But there's a Chocobo lore here. Yeah, so this is this session is nothing but Chocobos, but it is also a bit abridged, folks, because if we were to do the entire Chocobo side quests in like one fell swoop, one session, it'd probably be, I'd say, ballpark figure 3.5-4 hours, and no one wants to watch that much Chocobo catching, Chocobo racing, Chocobo fucking, Chocobo cuddling, Chocobo night out in Fogo de Chao. Brazilian Steakhouse. What about you, Nathan? I don't know if you want to watch that, but...
I didn't like doing it. Why would I want to watch it?
Yeah, you know, hey, man, you never know. I ain't judging. But, so the chocobos are gone. I'm guessing whoever rented them out is not using the stables anymore. So, you know what? We're having similar issues as last time. I better lower the resolution for the game. One second, guys. And I'm broadcasting from my computer. I thought this issue would be fixed.
And while we wait, John, what did you think of Kingdom Hearts 2.5?
I'm still playing it.
Yeah, I'm still playing it myself.
Okay. The lower resolution should make things a little smoother. Sorry about that, folks. I don't know why, it's like Final Fantasy VII lately has become more of a memory hog. Even though it's... Oh, I get it, I'm running the PS4 version after all, so... I shouldn't fret. Let me get that Chocobo lore material again. Let me, put that on... I'm gonna get both of these on cloud.
Yes.
Yeah, I've done some materia grinding off screen between sessions. You know, I got the Chocobo lore up to 2 stars. I had it at Master at 1 save file. I just, you know, just forgot to load that one. But I got 2 of them. Where the hell is my counterattack? Did I put that on Sid? Yeah, he doesn't need that. Cloud needs that. Gonna be needing all of that. And for this session, I'm going to have a powerful combination with Tifa equipped. You guys remember the Cursed Ring. I had that on Vincent in previous sessions. Well, I have it on Tifa now, combined with her Power Soul weapon, which, you know, as you see the description says, power up when near death. When you have the Cursed Ring on, you're considered near death. So Tifa is going to be hitting people in the face really fucking hard. And I don't know about you guys, but I hate getting hit in the face. So the Chocobo stables are empty. You talk to Choco Bill here. You know, I guess because of the meteor and the shit is going and it's just getting real. The rocket strategy didn't work. You're welcome. So the Chocobo stables are free to rent. There are 6 in total and they each cost 10,000 gil apiece. So $60,000 to load up on the entire stable. Now you're probably wondering, folks, like, hey, John, what the fuck? Your gil counter just, like, went up to, like, 1 million. 1.6 million, to be exact. Well, off-screen, I did some materia grinding, well, level grinding, around Medeal. They gave out a lot of AP. And with Sid's Scimitar, which is triple AP growth, you can max out an all-materia pretty fast. And a mastered all-materia sells for 1.4 million gil. That is a lot of money. So, I went and mastered one of those, and I sold, so I have a lot of money for the amount of greens I'm going to buy for this fucking side quest. Well, I'm not going to be buying much, but I do need them primarily for buying some Chocobo stables. Chocobos are hard to take care of, just do it yourself. We just hold the Chocobos.
You do the rest.
If we stare at them and we notice that this one's malnourished and it's on the verge of collapsing, the only thing we can say is, wow, I hope their owners come back soon. Take care of my chocobos. There is a chocobo, I need a chocobo stable, and they rent for 10,000 gils. Currently, I can rent up to 6 chocobo stables. You can keep 4 around the fenced area, 6 inside the stables. Now, this part's a bit annoying, because, you know, you want to rent all 6 at once, but you have to keep, you know, individually selecting rented.
Yeah. I never like this part.
Bluebird 86 calls me a gillionaire. You know, the exchange rate for gil is pretty shit. It's like 1.4 million gil is like $10 in America.
1.4.
Far. I'm clued from Pennsylvania.
My friend is Lunk.
And my girlfriend's Patch.
She lives in Texas. She fight good.
How many? I forgot how many I rented. I think I'm at 4 now. Let me see.
I wasn't keeping track.
I wasn't either. Let's see. All I'm going to find out now is, like, we can rent the 6 Chocobo stables. 7, please. I'll repeat myself. 6 Chocobo stables.
400?
I'm sorry, I said I could buy the ranch. I'm pretty sure I can afford it. Okay, I think that was 6. Let me see if I can... We don't have enough room to rent out more than 6 here, rich boy.
So you're saying I can have 7?
Tifa just has this look of disbelief on Cloud.
I love Cloud.
I love this man. Alright. This is Chocobo Billy. We talked to him earlier. I think he sold us the Chocobo lore materia at first for 2,000 gil way back in Disc 1. We're going to buy some greens here. The cheapest ones, because I'm a cheap fuck. Geisel. Or Geisel. I don't know how you pronounce that. Let me see. 10? 10 should be enough. Why not? I don't plan on using them all, but... Okay. So, the primary goal of this side quest is that we're going for the ultimate prize, I would say, of Final Fantasy VII, which is the Gold Chocobo. Now, why do we want a Gold Chocobo? It's because, well, there are special colored chocobo in Final Fantasy VII that can travel through certain terrain. There's the green chocobo, which can travel through mountains. There's the blue chocobo, which can travel through shallow water. There is the black chocobo, which can go through mountains and rivers and shallow water. And finally, there's the gold chocobo, which can go anywhere. So how do you make a gold chocobo? You gotta do a lot of chocobo breeding. We gotta make a green chocobo. We gotta make a blue chocobo. We gotta make them fucking make a black chocobo. Then we gotta get a wonderful chocobo over at the northern area, the icicle area, and then make it fuck with that, and then we can get a gold chocobo. We gotta get nuts, we gotta race them, and, you know, let's get started. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna get some K-Rob nuts.
K-Rob.
K-Rob. Oh, that's how I pronounce them. C-A-R-O-B. Where's this fucking island? Now, here it is.
There's the fucking island.
There's the fucking island. I got the fucking island. I'm here. Let's get some. Make sure the steel materia is on. I got it on Cloud because, you know, he has the best chances of stealing shit besides Yuffie. And we just gotta run around here for a bit.
Hi, I'm Cloud.
There he is. That wasn't very long. Alright, this guy has like over 33,000 HP. We're not gonna kill him. We're just gonna steal a run. Yay! First try.
Blah.
Hey, that was my nut!
You take my Carob nut?
You no take Carob nut. Give Carob nut back. Now, I don't know what the hell nuts are supposed to be and why they are needed when you are mating chocobos. Is it like an engagement ring?
Aphrodisiac?
Oh, God. Shit, I never thought of that. It's a roofie! You son of a bitch!
When a male chocobo and a lady chocobo like each other very much, the male chocobo gives the lady a nut, and then she passes out and does not remember anything.
Oh my God. Yeah, the people in the chat are saying the same thing. Fertility drug. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Johnny, why is Cloud promoting date rape of birds?
I don't know. Where the hell is this dinosaur at? Hey, you take one nut from him and suddenly he's a bitch. Me know like three people. Three people steal nuts.
Okay, Tarzan.
It's a dinosaur. I don't think it speaks coherent English.
What? How do you know? For all we know, dinosaurs in our own age could speak fluent German. We don't know that.
That is a story to tell. I don't have to worry about Cloud killing this thing, because again, it has like over 33,000 HP. Come on, give me your nut.
What is the dinosaur doing with the nut anyway?
I don't know. Oh, come on. Stop being a greedy little whore. I just want your nut.
Okay, I remember last session when I said like when Cloud's trying to steal from Reno and Rude, he's just like putting his hand in his pocket.
Yeah.
You're stealing nuts from this dinosaur. Are you just walking up like feeling it? Like what Yay. Are you doing?
I stole your K-Rob nut, and good news, there is no testicular cancer. Anyway.
I'm completely a doctor. I can use the cure materia. What?
That's two. One more. Isn't this exciting, ladies and gentlemen?
Give me your nuts, Johnny 2015.
Now, you can generally tell who you're going to fight based off the camera angles when the battle starts. Like, if the battle begins with a blue sky here on this island, that usually means you're going to fight the dinosaur. I keep saying dinosaur because I don't remember its damn name. I think it started with a V, though. Velociraptor, maybe? Nah, that's too generic.
I don't know, nothing is out of bounds for
you
Final
know,
Fantasy.
It's really weird, is this him? Oh, damn it, no, you teased me! You know, in previous Final Fantasies, you know, the hub on the bottom usually told you the party name, the HP, time, and the enemy names. In this game, I think this is the only game, the later games in the series, you have to, like, actively select the enemy and hit, like, the assist button to see what the name is.
Whoa.
Yeah, because it isn't it in this one you have to use the sense materia in order to see all that stuff?
Well, you gotta use the sense materia to get HP, levels, and weakness. Oh, shit. Just level 4 suicide at me. Suicided.
Kamikaze!
Luckily, the fucks are at 0 for today, folks. I just want a K-Rob nut.
I just want to fondle the dinosaur again.
Yeah, these are... I don't know if these nuts are... like the typical, you know, store variety. I'm pretty sure you can't go to the Midgar Walmart and buy mixed nuts and say, I think this is a K-Rob nut. Give it to the Chocobo, see what it thinks. I like cashews.
So the people of Midgar like the people of Walmart, all ghetto-fied and stuff?
It came from Midgar. Where the hell is this damn dinosaur? I fought like 3 in a row in a test playthrough last night.
It knows, John. It knows you're castrating
it. It's that. Hiding in a ditch. It has the most puppy dog eyes, hoping I don't see it.
Please stay away.
Stop him a nut!
No bad touch. Creepy touch induces sadness.
There it is, thank God. Gimme. Thank you. We're out of here. I'm not going to kill this thing. I just want his nut. All right, let's head back to Goblin Island. Now, I should have done this beforehand to save 2 trips, but, you know, whatever. I'm not going to worry about gas in this world. Oh, for God's sakes, I'm fucking tripping balls.
I love how Cloud is tall enough to peek over the top of the forest. Is he really just, like, walking through a bush? It's just...
Well, that's a logical conclusion. I steal a nut. This guy punches me in the face. Okay, that's it for the nuts. Look at all the nuts I have. I got 3 K-Robs and 1 Zeo.
I think but look at Zeo. All the fucks you give. Yeah. You have none.
No, I do not. Alright, let's go back to the Chocobo Sage. I was here earlier to get his enemy skill material, then I left. Because I'm a jerk.
Because I'm Cloud.
Yeah. Oh, I overshot it. Shit. Here it is. Such a relaxing place. You! Soon. That's it. That's all I got.
Tonight. You.
Now... ladies and gentlemen, when you're playing Final Fantasy VII, I'm just going to say straight up, like, if you're going for Chocobo reading all that, read a guide. It's just so much easier, comprehensive, and it saves a lot of time. But in-game, in order to learn about everything about color Chocobo breeding, you got to talk to the Chocobo Sage, this guy right here. The problem is that when you ask him to remember anything, he's not going to remember everything all at once. I think it's battle-based on how many times he can, how many battles you fight in order to get him to remember something else, or maybe it's entering and exiting an area amount of times, but this guy will eventually tell you the complete method of how to breed blue, green, black, and gold Chocobos. Now, in the case you don't write any of this down, if you head back to the Chocobo stable and talk to the second person inside the ranch, she will jot the notes down for you. A little more legible, actually. And that's how you can use it as a refresher course. You know, I'm just showing them off for the sake of, you know. Is this guy one of those ancients from the Temple of Ancients? With a hat?
Look at his hat.
Or purple slimer, maybe. But Chocobo Sage here also has the best greens in the game, the Silcus, that's how I pronounce them anyway. 5,000 gil a pop, unfortunately, they're really expensive, but Silcus greens are so awesome, you don't really need to feed your Chocobo that many to max out their stats for racing. So, for this, I'm actually not going to be doing much, but, you know, that's where you can buy them, because folks, this is how it's going to be abridged. I am going to go to the areas where you have to catch the chocobo, well, the required chocobos to get the breeding, requirements down packed. And then I'm going to load up a save file I made last night, so we can get to the breeding that matters. Because, again, if we went down the entire Chocobo session, like, from beginning to end with no cutting, that's like 3.5-4 hours of nothing but Chocobo breeding and racing and catching, and that's not very fun to watch. So, in order to make a green and blue Chocobo, we need to mate a great Chocobo and a good Chocobo. Now, there is a guide that states that it's very possible to do it with, like, two greats or two goods, I guess, if you don't want the stats to be as good. I don't know exactly how that works, but I do know the tried and true method is mating a great Chocobo with a good Chocobo. So we're going to go after great Chocobos first, which are here in Medeal.
Great!
No, it's not great, Nathan. It's not.
Not yet.
Not great, Nathan.
No.
I'm going to set my configuration to wait, because the last thing I need is the active time battle making them work. I hate when Chocobos work. Wark.
Wark.
Sorry, I don't know.
Wark.
Award-winning commentary here, ladies and gentlemen. It's session 14 of Final Fantasy VII Live. We have two Chocobo lords equipped to the cloud, so that we should be getting the Chocobo battles. I hope this is the one I'm looking for. Yes, okay, this is a great Chocobo. You can tell from the enemy formations. I don't remember the name of these assholes right here. But these are the formations you want to look for. If you see a Chocobo with two of these guys in the front, that's a great Chocobo. So let me get my Geischel Greens, which I should have put in the top of the list. Now I got to go through my Winchesters, my armlets. It's like I'm running through a toy chest, just throwing everything out looking for my greens. Where are my greens?
Maybe you did put them at the top and you did not realize it.
No. I would have remembered that shit. Cloud, you're eating them. Oh! Throw them at the Chocobo, Cloud.
Have a salad!
I probably should have used Tifa's Limit Break outside because I don't want a dolphin kick the bird. There we go, this should kill it.
Caught a Chocobo! Yay!
Yay!
We did it!
We did it! Yeah!
Now, time to fry it.
Look what I have! This will feed me for an entire day. Yeah, so you know, cash Chocobo, we've done this before. But now that we have a stable over back at the Chocobo stables, when you dismount, you're given the option. Do you release it, or send it back to your stables? Let's not ask how it crosses the oceans to get back to the stables. These are the questions they do not want you to think about.
No, these are the questions I'm going to think about. How the fuck does that thing know where to go?
I don't know. It jumps. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound.
Okay, super bird.
Alright, that's our great Chocobo. Now, here's the other thing, another factor that's thrown into the equation. Gender. Yeah, it's not just a matter of, you know, you can't have two males, mate. You can't have two females, mate. That's not how eggs are produced, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry. You gotta have a female and male Chocobo mate. Now, which one has to be great and good does not matter. But gender is not determined until you decide to move the Chocobo into the stable. When you catch a Chocobo and send it back to the stable, it's going to be in this fenced area right here. It's not ready to be moved just yet. We're going to go inside now and see what all the hubbub is about. Let's talk to Chocobo Billy here. I'm sorry, Choco Billy. And let's move it.
Does Cloud have to Choco Billy? Da 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 da.
Bop! Yep, see? This is a great... Yeah, by the way, the lighting in the PC version of this is shit. This Chocobo is dark.
What do you got against dark Chocobo?
I like dark meat. Well, I like certain dark meat. Work. After a while, yeah. Work. Put it in, and this is when the gender is determined. So we have a female great Chocobo in this case. Nathan, give me a name.
Bird.
Is that B-I-R-D or B-U-R-D?
B-U-R-D.
Okay, bird. Oh, shit. No, learn how to spell, John.
Actually, make it birdie. Still using the U.
Okay. Birdie, there you go.
That could be read either way, and I'm okay with
whatever.
That.
Whatever. I think that's feminine.
We had, in the chat, we had Yoshi, Bort, Bird, Megert, KFC. The girl.
Boko, we're not playing Final Fantasy V. But a nice reference nonetheless. Alright, now let's go for the pain in the ass. A good chocobo is around the gold saucer area, but folks, Jesus Christ, I had the worst luck catching this thing, because you gotta have two very specific formations in order to get a good chocobo.
That thing.
That thing. What the fuck was I saying?
Nightfang Bugenhagen. I don't think you have enough letters to name it that.
No, I don't. No, this is not what I'm looking for.
This is, run away!
No, this monstrosity is next to another monstrosity. This is an average chocobo, I believe. We are looking for a chocobo that has two... Let me see the name of it. I remember the name, but they're Spencers. It's like these little... I don't know what the fuck they are, but they're blue. That's a good chocobo, and I also believe a chocobo with two flat beats behind it is considered a good chocobo. Either way, you know, this is what you're doing for, like, a majority... No, this is not. This is an average chocobo, because the flat beats are in front of the chocobo. You want the opposite. Ay, ay, ay.
And here it goes.
Wait, I forgot to put the Geishul Greens on top. I should probably do that.
Yeah, you might want to do that.
Look how much shit I have! Oh wait, you actually gotta go to Customize. In, 7. You know, in older Final Fantasies, you can just go to an item, hit Select. I think it's still- I'm not sure if that still works here. But, you gotta actively- there you go.
And here we go.
No, that's not it either.
You're not loved.
You're average, you hear me? Chocobilly think you're so-so. Gotta capture you and make you name you so-so, and then immediately release you.
Chocobilly think you're so-so? Yeah. Chocobilly needs a grammar lesson.
Hey, I'm just saying what they say in the game. Like this one's so what? This one, yeah, this one's in front of the flat beats. Good. Yes, it is good. All right, Tifa, give it a green. I'm gonna chop this one in the face.
Mark.
Sid, punch that one with your large man hand.
Wait, did that just say Wark KKK?
Yes. It has a stuttering problem.
Oh, I was about to say, this chocobo's racist.
Oh, no.
We got it. We did it. Now, let's hope it has a penis.
God, yeah, you're right. Yeah, that... Ay, ay, ay. There's so many factors that makes me hate this thing, ladies and gentlemen. All right, let's send it back to the stables. Now, remember when I said that gender is determined when you decide to move it into the stable, so, to save yourself time, save the game before you enter the stable. Where the fuck am I going? Here we are.
Wee! Now, Tifa, let go of the steering wheel, you can't drive!
The problem here with the PC version is that, well... There's an RNG counter for Chocobo specifically, what determines race, what determines, the kind of chocobo you're gonna get when you breed them, or mate them, I should say. All that shit. It was really easy in the PS1 version to manipulate that by soft resetting. For those who don't know what I'm talking about, if you hit all four of the shoulder buttons, hit start and select, you reset the game from within the game. You can't do that in the PC version. As far as I'm aware, there is no soft resetting in the Steam version of Final Fantasy VII, so I have to manually hard reset to... manipulate shit. But the problem here is that soft resetting in the PS1 version advanced the RNG counter. So you can just keep soft resetting until you get your desired result. If you don't get the desired result in the Steam version, in this case, I want a male a good chocobo here, then I have to not only reset the game, but I have to advance that RNG counter. In this case, in advancing the RNG counter, you can do that via battling, I believe, and entering and exiting the stable repeatedly. So I'm going to move this good chocobo, it should be good anyway, and if it's not male, I have to reset the game, go inside the stable repeatedly like a dumbass to manipulate that RNG counter so that I can finally get my my male good chocobo.
Yes.
Okay, this seems like a good chocobo. It is a good chocobo. I don't know why they keep saying, and all they scare me by saying this seems like a good chocobo. Oh no, it looks like it has hepatitis.
This seems like a good chocobo, but it's kind of holding a knife and giving a menacing look. I don't think it's too good.
All right. Drum roll, Nathan.
Ba-da!
Joy to the world!
Okay.
Damn it!
Oh! No!
That's not a male. So, what do? We have the hard reset. Boop!
We booped.
It begins. It fucking begins. Alright, so that was obviously a female, so now we have to advance that RNG counter. We're gonna go inside the stable. I'd say maybe 2-3 times. Advance it.
You will have a penis, yeah.
Grow one! Or else.
Johnny wants the good chocobo D badly.
Yeah, I need a gold chocobo. Alright, let's see. That should advance the counter in some sort.
You will have a penis?
Is that a question? Put it in. Yay! There you go. Okay, that
it has a penis!
It has a dick! Oh my god, it has a dick! Okay. I'll let the chat name this one. First name I see that's not vulgar, I will put it up. Birdo, okay. Birdie and Birdo. Hey, it is masculine, so kudos.
Don't call it white meat.
Yeah. Okay, so we have a female and a male chocobo. We can get to the breeding if we want to have a very slim chance of getting a colored chocobo, unfortunately. Now, it is very possible to... you know what? We're going to try it now. Why not? We're not going to race just yet. We're going to see what happens. It's a very slim chance. It could work, though. Now, the thing you're supposed to do to ensure, like, guaranteed colored chocobo when you mate the two together is you gotta take the chocobos to chocobo racing, you know, the gold saucer. All newborn or freshly caught chocobos they begin at rank C. So you take them chocobo racing and you make them race 3 times per rank to increase the rank. The max is S. You go from C, B, A, S. Alphabet, ladies and gentlemen. Did I say it? I didn't say it, did I?
Just to be sure, save 11 more times.
Yeah. So, you know, just for shits and giggles, let's have them mate now. If they don't make a color chocobo, I really doubt it's going to happen, because out of all the playthroughs I've had in Final Fantasy VII, folks, that's only worked to me a grand total of once. So, you know, let's mate them. Let's see if it works. That way I can skip to the abridged version really fast.
Which two chocobos are you going to mate? Do you...
There's only two here. Oh, are you making fun of my hair? Fuck you!
We have Birdo and Birdie.
Twirly whirly bird. Twirly whirly. Alright. This is why we got the K-Rob nuts for. You gotta give them K-Rob nuts, folks. And survey says...
Come on. Be abnormal.
Hey, look at that! I didn't even have to race him!
Yay.
I think this is blue. And it's a female.
I think it's having a seizure.
This is not going to matter because I'm going to load up a save file soon, folks. So, we're going to call him Chalk.
Her. Her name is Chalk.
Okay, that is a blue chocobo. I think it's blue. I can't tell because the landing is kind of warped. I'm warped. That's the pun.
From what it looks like for me, it looks blue.
It looks blue, yeah. The lighting in when you're moving chocobos is a bit wonky. But yeah, now you would think the logical thing now is to get the chocobos to mate again. Unfortunately, after a chocobo and another chocobo get busy with disco fever for one night only, they gotta wait a bit. You know, the engine's not running. You know, they're not feeling it. So, in order to get them primed and ready for more breeding, you have to battle. In this case, I believe, to reset the mate counter, you have to battle at least 10 times. After 10 battles, the chocobos will be ready. Now, that only applies to chocobos that you've, like, caught. A newly born chocobo, colored or not, cannot breed until, I think, after... It's a random number between 10 and 18. And you have to fight a certain amount of battles to get them up and ready to go. Now, you now understand why I'm now going to load up a previous save file, because nobody wants to watch me battle like 20 times. And, you know, I'll just load up the save file and see, let you guys know what we're going to do. So let me exit this out. I really wish, like, I thought my computer was powerful enough to not cause so much, because the game is running a little slow, I've noticed. You know, it's not so much the stream lagging, folks. I mean, the game is running a little slow on the computer, and I apologize for that. I'm trying to get a new computer for this year. It's one of my, you know, I just gotta make a budget for that shit. Alright, so this right here on the bottom is a save file I made yesterday, you know, to prep for this thing. Let me go down what's here. So. Off screen. I have the great and good chocobo, that's all nice, and I have both a blue and green chocobo here, because, the process of getting the blue and green chocobo is also determined by RNG. The great and good chocobo combination that got you the blue chocobo can also give you the green chocobo. You don't have to switch the great and good chocobo around. The genders don't mean anything in terms of reversing it. It doesn't matter. You can still get both a green and blue chocobo from the same pair, which I did last night. I was really lucky. It was like the next chocobo to breed, and I was feeling really happy about that. Now, off screen, I have raced these chocobos. Like, in a test playthrough, I made Choka and Choka, those are the females, those are the names I gave them. I raced them to Class A, because when they're at Class A, folks, you're pretty much guaranteed to get a blue or green chocobo when you breed them. Now, in order to get the next chocobo in the lineup, a black chocobo, you need the corresponding blue and green chocobos. One has to be blue and one has to be female. Let me tell you, that is a fucking pain in the ass when you need a specific color, and not only does it need to be a specific color, it needs to be a specific gender. So, the amount of resetting will be high when you do this for the first time, folks. Nathan, what do you think? I like KFC.
You sounded very angry at that.
It is annoying, man. Like, I love Final Fantasy VII. I love this game, Johnny, but I hate chocobo breeding. It is just... It starts so slow, and admittedly, yes, it does speed up when you're narrowing it down, but, oh my god, it's just... Why? Why, Nathan? Why?
Why not?
So, off screen, I have also raced my blue and green chocobos to Class A. I named the blue one Gaia, and the green one Terra. First one to get that reference gets an internet cookie, go! But, so, they're good to go. So we're gonna mate them.
I've seen two people in the chat keep saying name it Bobby Corwin.
Who?
I don't know. One of them's Ryan, so.
I don't know who that is.
Neither do I. Planetary sex.
These planets are going to bump buglies with each other. That's right, I said bump buglies.
Somebody was drinking the live stream again, weren't they?
All right, so now we're going to have Gaia and Terra mate. And then we're going to give them our last K-Rob nut, because, again, we caught three total, and we had to use two to get the green and blue chocobo, respectively. But we have to use... Oh, shit, I got to get a Zeo nut for this file. I forgot about that. Yes. Let's give it to them. A bow chickawawa. A lot of people in the chat are telling me to name it KFC.
Yeah, I'm getting a lot of KFCs. Hey, KFC, it's crispy chicken.
Hell yeah, but this one's kind of burnt. Like, I wouldn't eat black chicken.
KFC. I'm more partial to Popeyes.
Well, it is Louisiana fast.
This chocobo might be Louisiana fast.
Wait, did I get the Silka screens? Why, Cloud's furious.
Oh, damn it. I just realized I made a subtle racist joke.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't hear it, so maybe it wasn't... I don't know. Whatever. I don't think I bought Silka screens from the Chocobo Sage. Let me, because they should be next to the Geisel greens.
You passed the Geisel greens.
Geisel greens. Yeah, the Silka screens are not here. Okay. So... Chocobos have three specific stats. Their speed, their stamina, and their intelligence. Silka screens raises all of those. And Silka screens are so powerful that you only need to buy a select few to get them all up to max. A black chocobo, total stats are pretty substantial because, you know, it's special.
Yay. I'm special.
I'm here for the greens, old man, if you know what I mean.
Why?
I mean, fuck it. You know, I never drew that parallel now. That's why he's isolated. This guy's selling ebony and ivory, if you catch my drift. By 20. Yeah, I just spent 100 grand on fucking weed. And it's not even for me!
It's for a fucking bird!
No, 99 silk. That's the Shadow of Midgard. 99 Silka screens. That's overkill, good sir. You only need about 20.
We want it high, not dead.
No, I think the minimum is 10. I think 20 is to be on the safe side. I did 15 in the test playthrough, but I'm doing 20 because fuck it, I got the money to spend. Dollar gill, y'all. So now let's feed it. Let's feed this son of a bitch.
Eat the grass.
Eat it!
Which chocobo are you gonna feed? We're gonna have some grass-fed KFC.
No. There you are. God, I can barely see the damn thing.
You looking for me?
I recall this being a lot faster in the PlayStation 1 version. Speed plus, stamina plus, they're getting along better.
Wait, what?
Well, that's what they said. Now, it didn't say intelligence plus, but the intelligence is raised regardless. I don't know why sometimes it tells that and sometimes it doesn't.
I just want to know, wait, why are they getting along better? Who is it getting along better with?
Alright. I gotta go get a Zeo nut again from the Goblin Island. And I also need to catch a wonderful chocobo for our last breeding session. And then we're gonna get to the bulk of this session, which is chocobo racing, folks. You know, because this black chocobo is fresh, primed, ready to race. But, you know, we gotta get there first. So let me wander around Goblin Island for a bit.
Time to go steal more nuts. Surprise castration. Some weird shit happens in video games.
Gentlemen, I've come for your nuts. Hey, thank you. You're such a nice guy.
Well, okay.
Alright. I think it's time for questions. I can't really read the chat box too much because I'm like concentrating on this. But Nathan, you can go right ahead.
I shall read the questions. When? Why Goku? What? The first question I see is why Goku? Why not Goku?
There we go.
Let's see. What FF game that optional boss have 50 million HP?
Wait, one more time?
What FF game that optional boss that have 50 million HP?
That's,
wow.
That's Yasmat from 12.
Yeah, that's... Somebody said that too. Will you ever do a live stream of FF9?
Oh, absolutely. My next live stream game, though, is not going to be Final Fantasy. I was thinking of, Actually, thank you for reminding me of that. I was actually thinking of live streaming Majora's Mask 3D. Would you guys be down for that? Nathan, you have to say yes. But
yeah. Well, of course. Seeing as how, and I know I'm gonna get chastised by everybody in the fucking chat for this, but this will be my first time ever completing Majora's Mask.
That's not that, you know, alien. You realize that?
You know. Honestly, I know I'm gonna get shit from Matt. I know I'm gonna get shit from Ryan. Because it's Matt and Ryan.
Wait, this is not the North Pole.
This isn't where I parked my car.
Yeah, well, speaking of, where's my dude buggy? I forgot all about that. I think it's still in front of Nibelheim. Hey, fuck it, I got time to waste. Check my dune buggy.
I mean, it's not like I don't know what happens in Majora's Mask. I've watched Chugga Conroy. I'm watching the Brain Scratch. I'm gonna watch TV when they get to it. It's going to. I know exactly what happens.
My dude buggy's gone. Dio, someone you will pay.
They jacked our ride.
All right, I think this is where the Chocobo tracks are. Yeah, there they are. Let me just fly sideways here.
As you fly sideways.
Anyway. Alright, any more questions, Nathan?
Let's see. Dude, where's my car? What about Massey? Dude, where our car?
That.
Hey, Johnny, you want a copy of Skullgirls?
Yeah, of course I'm gonna say yeah, but, it's very generous of you. Folks, there's another thing. I'm sorry, like, if I don't immediately respond to, like, Twitter questions and Facebook questions that I get. You know, I'm pretty busy, and I only get, like, maybe 5 or 10 minutes of the day to check Twitter and Facebook when I get the chance. Because I'm staring at a video editor for most of the time. This isn't a damn chocobo!
Somebody asked, do you smoke weed?
Oh, shit. I completely forgot what gender my black chocobo was. But it doesn't matter, we can save the game.
Your black chocobo?
Yeah.
Pretty sure it's male.
This is not a wonderful chocobo. I think the wonderful chocobo, if I remember correctly, had the bunny creatures next to it. So, the search goes on.
Nathan, who is doing Pokemon next? Why are you asking me?!
What?
Ryan says, why aren't you playing FF9?
Because I'm playing FF7.
There you go, Ryan. Yep, everyone says your black chocobo's male.
Okay, thanks. I appreciate that, guys. You guys have better fucking eyesight than I do. I am a bit fatigued, though.
Yeah. Will SGB play Borderlands or any other FPS?
You would have to... I never played a Borderlands game. I think... from a hand-me-down, I think I have two. Because Mark was into Borderlands for a while, then he dropped it.
Have you ever played DDR?
Oh, yeah. I was all over DDR in the mid-2000s. I still DDR every once in a while, but not nearly as much as I used to. I always like doing Suguru on Heavy. As a crowd pleaser, because I love the galloping section in the middle. What about you? You ever played DDR?
Yeah, I have DDR Universe 3 for my 360.
Yeah.
And
back when my uncle had Dance Dance Revolution Extreme.
Yeah.
For the PS2, Suguru was my favorite song to play.
Yeah, it was the first song I ever saw someone else play on Heavy, and I was just so amazed. I was like, I gotta learn this. I have to do this now. All right, folks, I paused the game here because I don't remember. I know the Chocobo with the two bunnies is a wonderful, but I don't remember if the Chocobo with the wolf and the bunny is wonderful. Does anybody remember this is wonderful?
Is this a wonderful life?
Is this a, yes. Johnny's heart can't keep up with the DDR anymore. Fuck you, Ryan. You got DDR all over your face. You got a gallop.
Will you live stream Corey in the house?
No.
But you gotta get those secret bobbleheads, Johnny. You gotta get them.
People are not sure in the chat themselves. I'm gonna err on the side of caution and just ignore it. I just go away for two bunnies.
Nathan, what do you think of Omega Ruby? I haven't bought the game yet. I don't have the money.
I have Omega Ruby. I haven't played it yet.
I haven't bought a video game since Smash Brothers.
Oh, well. That should keep you tied for another 6 months.
Yeah. We'll brain scratch play Cards Against Humanity at MomoCon. I will buy a bunch of packs if we can record ourselves doing that. I will bring Cards Against Humanity to MomoCon.
Gaz Manific, I'm guessing I'm pronouncing that right. Bunny plus Wolf is not a wonderful Chocobo. Warning, that Chocobo is not wonderful. It's a bit of an asshole.
He likes to spit on little children.
And then lick their tears.
What's your favorite anime? Basher573's is Corey in the house. God, people.
Tenshu 1886 asked, Johnny, which Pokemon game is Brain Scratch doing? And promise me Ted is not doing it. Too bad! Ted's doing Pokemon Emerald. Yeah, Ted is doing Emerald at some point or another. Because, look, he's probably the biggest Pokemon guy next to Ryan. And I actually think Ryan is probably the biggest. No, this is not a wonderful Chocobo. And I think Ryan and Ted are the biggest Pokemon nerds in the group. You know, I play every once in a while, but I don't not to the extent. But, yeah, you know. It depends on when Ted wants to record Gen 3, though, you know?
And, I've seen this in the chat a couple times. I have to answer it. Yes, I'm going to MomoCon.
Yes. End of May, folks. Get your tickets now.
Yes.
Strudel.
Boogenhagen.
Yeah, speaking of which, we're like not advancing plot at all in this session, folks. The Boogenhagen is like, where is Cloud? We got the keys of the ancients and it's nowhere to be found.
My leader wasn't rising up.
Oh my god, come on.
When is the Kirby Marathon?
At some point or another. I'm actually gonna do it, because, you know, people took my comments at the end of, like, the Generation 2 review seriously. Like, fuck Kirby. Fuck Kirby doesn't deserve a marathon.
Kirby doesn't deserve it.
Yeah, people are like, folks, that was just a joke. I was like, I play Kirby. Kirby was one of my first Game Boy games.
Emily would kill you if there wasn't a Kirby Marathon. Emily loves Kirby.
Aw.
Nathan,
N64 Maddie.
BSC Panlay.
Wait, what?
No, I'm not. I'm going to watch it, hopefully.
Is Nathan going to join the Brain Scratch panel de pon? Was it N64 Maddie? I think that was what his name was. The next large Brain Scratch commentary is soon ish. Not for like another like 2 or 3 months, but we got two major whoppers on the way. Both I'm really looking forward to, because, I love those games.
Why does everybody keep asking you this?
What?
What's your favorite Sonic game?
You know, Nathan, the thing is that, you know, as I continue to make videos, my subscriber count goes up. I'm very, very grateful for that. You know, but you get new people who you're not here for previous live stream sessions, and you have to repeat a lot of answered questions, and, you know, well, it's pretty obvious that I love Sonic 3 and Knuckles the most.
You answer this question in almost every Sonic video you do, though.
Well, I'm kind of asking for it if it's a Sonic-related video. Did anybody download that gig, like, patch for Boom? Like, does it do anything? I haven't done it myself, because I haven't put Boom on in a while.
Donnie said he didn't see any noticeable differences.
Ah, what a waste of time.
Amargo 313. I was at YumaCon for 2013. No, I went to YumaCon in 2013 with the Sonic Paradox guys.
Looking the wrong way. Fuck it. If you're not gonna give me any attention of the day, I'm not gonna give you any attention of the day.
If I can say anything, we had a 32 person panel.
Jesus Christ, that was the Sonic Paradox panel, right?
Yep.
Holy hell. How much time did you guys have?
About an hour and a half.
Oh, Lord.
It was mainly the Wax and three other main people, and we were all just sitting
just
up there.
Just watching. Judging.
Yeah.
Everyone's saying they fixed the infinite jumping glitch with Knuckles. Oh, why remove a feature?
Why would remove something good?
Yeah.
Nipples the enchilada.
Big shrugs with those rock hard fist nipples. Awfully cold tonight, wouldn't you say?
Will Tails doll ever come back? What are your opinions on Sonic Battle?
You know, that's like one of the only Sonic games I've yet to fully experience. I love the sprite work in that game, though.
I have a lot of history with Sonic Battle.
Yeah.
Well, like I was telling you before we started the stream, my history with Sonic 3, or Sonic Advance 3, the same thing happened with Sonic Battle. Me and my neighbor are big Sonic fans, and we gifted the games to each other, so we would play against each other multiple times, and yeah.
That's nice.
Easy way to earn all the moves and stuff.
Oh yeah, because it's like a social bonus.
Yeah.
It's like Street Passing and Bravely Default.
Yeah, actually. Are you still waiting for Mewtwo and Super Smash Bros. For Wii U and 3DS?
Yeah.
Yeah, it comes out in March.
We're all waiting.
it comes out in March. As does the soundtrack. I can't wait.
Oh, poor Club Nintendo. I hear they're shutting that down. They're replacing it with a new rewards program. I'm not sure what that is. But you know what? Thinking back, I got more out of the Nintendo Digital Deluxe promotion for the Wii U than I ever did for Club Nintendo.
The only reason I ever used Club Nintendo was to get the Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time 3D soundtrack and for Smash Brothers for Mewtwo and the soundtrack. It's really all I used it for.
Yeah, I think the soundtrack is going to be my last Club Nintendo reward. I mean, I don't even know if I have any coins left. I'm going to check. Maybe I can get some digital downloads. But,
man, I still have my Mario Galaxy soundtrack somewhere. I gotta find that.
Ay, ay, ay.
What? Hey, Nathan, what is Johnny's relationship with Elliot and Matt? What?
Huh? Elliot's my brother, Matt's my best friend? He's probably new. Or she. Like, I don't know.
Tenchu 1886.
I can't tell if that's masculine or feminine. What do you say, jumping bunnies that doesn't have a chocobo next to them?
Why don't you have a chocobo? When will Brain Scratch do Mega Man Star Force? That's probably something Ryan might do, right?
Maybe. I know nothing of Star Force.
John, Nathan, what were your guys' first game consoles?
Mine was a Super Nintendo. That's the first console I ever owned. No. It was a Genesis. Long, long time ago. I think it was... I want to say... Because I got my Super Nintendo in 94. I want to say 93 then. It was for a very short time. Like, maybe a few months. Then I don't know what happened. It was a long time ago, so I don't have a clear memory.
Mine was the Super Nintendo.
First game besides Mario World? Doesn't count. Mine was Batman Returns on the SNES.
Trying to think. The one that I remember was Super Mario All Stars. I remember my dad showing me how to do the one up trick. But Mark is Johnny real brother. What?
Ah, asshole.
Oh, hi, Mark. Will you play Battle Network?
Well, not the one I think they're talking about, but, you know, stay tuned. Dota's marathon's still going on. It's not a Battle Network Game Boy Advance game, but it's a... I don't know. I haven't played it yet.
Oh, you're talking about what I think you're talking about, then...
Yeah.
Yeah. Network Transmission?
GameCube game, yes.
Yeah. I enjoyed that game, actually.
I haven't played it yet, so I'm going to leave my opinions on mute until then.
On that.
Because I'm actually going through a lot of the games in the Donators Marathon. I'm going through blind. Like, usually I play a game that I'm reviewing. I play it fully, like, maybe one or two times. I know at least one time, maybe twice, if I either really like it or really hate it. But for the Donators Marathon, the reviews are really not only my first impressions, but whether or not I can recommend it to you based on those first impressions. You know? I'm being a little loose with the Donators Marathon in terms of writing, you know? Just, you know, it's not a much of... I don't have to be that professional, damn it. I'm a nice guy.
John, Nathan, what are your favorite legendaries?
At the risk of sounding cliche, Mewtwo. You know? I never... No, I think Lugia would probably be second place. You know, because I never found any fascination with Ho-Oh. You know, I never... The three legendary dogs, Suicune, Raikou, and Entei, I think it was.
Yes.
Didn't really find those appealing, and I can't say anything about Gen 3. Gen 4, I don't even remember. Like, besides Dialga and Palkia, and whatever Platinum was.
Dialga, Palkia, Giratina,
There's also those three psychic things. I think those are legendaries.
Masperit, Azelf, and Uxie.
Yeah. I don't remember those often. Registeel, Regice, and I think those are Gen 3.
Those are Gen 3.
Those are Gen 3, yeah. I don't remember much of them because... Hey, holy fucking hell! Where the hell is this wonderful Chocobo?
Technically, we are... Technically, the legendary dogs are beasts because, Raikou's clearly a tiger.
No, he's not.
Look at him! He is clearly a fucking tiger!
No, he's not. Is this it? Oh, for God's sakes, come on!
Nope.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just joining us here for Session 14 of Final Fantasy VII Live, this is the Chocobo session. I've loaded up a previous save file where I already have a green and blue and black Chocobo, and now I'm just in the process of getting a wonderful Chocobo, the last Chocobo I need to catch to get the gold Chocobo, and this son of a bitch is not- You're not even looking at me! Nathan, I want some hot cocoa. Why don't you ship me one of those manwiches your friend made you?
I'll man the hot cocoa cannon.
Fuck yeah, so metal.
it might not be so hot by the time it gets to Philadelphia.
Oh no, you shoot it out of the stratosphere. When it re-enters, it'll be burnt to a crisp. But I think I can still eat it.
It might be edible.
Do I think I can ride this chocobo if it fucking shows up?
There ain't no getting off this train.
I don't think it matters what tracks you run on top of, folks. You know, tracks are tracks. You know, I was running around these for a little bit, and I was running around those for a little bit. I hear the music, but I need the right formation. No! For God's sakes! Holy shit! Like, this is RNG fucking with me, right? Oh, you want to run away before I do, huh?
Nope.
I'll have to throw some dynamite in your fucking ass. Fuck it. I'm very angry.
Nathan, do you seriously plan on bringing Cards Against Humanity to MomoCon? Yes, if that's going to be a possibility of getting recorded, yes, I'll bring my video camera too.
I don't even know what
1080p
that is.
Cards Against Humanity.
Don't even know what that is.
Work.
I don't speak work. All right, come on, I hear the electric music. I hear the electric. Oh, God, come on. Like, where is this wonderful chocobo? I want to ride this wonderful chocorodeo. I want to be a trailblazer.
Nathan, do you or Johnny ever watch JoJo?
JoJo's Bizarre Adventure? No, I've seen the Dreamcast game in action. That was actually my first exposure to JoJo's Bizarre Adventure was the Dreamcast game.
Wonderful 101 Chocobo.
Yeah, it'll be 101 battles by the time we get the damn thing. But this is like the most notorious part of 7, folks. Like, Chocobo racing. Some would argue the battle arena. You know, trying to get Omni Slash and the W summon materia, the final attack materia. Chocobo racing. It's just, God, if you have miserable RNG, you could be here for fucking ever.
Yep.
Come on, I hear the tunes. I hear the tunes. It's not the fucking right one.
John, Nathan, what are your thoughts on Pokemon Mystery Dungeon?
I never played it.
I have. I love them. They're interesting little takes away from the actual Pokemon games. I mean, how many times can you, as a Pikachu and a Chimchar, beat the ever-living fuck out of Dialga and Palkia?
It's here! It's fucking here! Oh, I found it! I don't run away! Eat it!
I would just like to let everybody know that John has found a wonderful chocobo.
Punch it in its goofy-ass nose, Tifa! You missed! What is going on?! It's missing!
The bunny is hopping.
Fuck you! Fuck you, okay? Make him a heart race! Oh! Jesus Christ!
Nathan, not meaning to sound rude, but if I may ask, where is Emily? Emily is actually back in my hometown attending college. Whereas I live in Disney World.
Where's my airship?
Have you tried Pokemon Conquest, the Nobunaga's Ambition crossover? Yes. I wasn't too fond of it.
Back to the Chocobo farm.
Alright.
Ranch.
My black Chocobo was male?
Yes.
Alright, then it needs to be female, so I'm gonna save the game beforehand. I'm just gonna manipulate that RNG until it has a vajayjay.
Nathan asked Johnny who's going to play the Oracle games.
For what, SGP or Brain Scratch?
I don't know, just this.
I'll handle it for SGP. I'm doing Link's Awakening soon-ish.
Yay.
Someone says you should have used a Master Ball.
You know what? I don't think I picked up that Chocobo lore for this save file. I'm gonna go check here on the opposite side of the fence. You know, because it wasn't a matter of just running into the Chocobo, folks. It's getting the right Chocobo. Yeah, I didn't pick up the Chocobo lore material for here. I think it'd be easier. I think it'd be faster if I exit via this way and go back in this way. Because before you start renting Chocobo stables, you spawn in the bottom of the screen right here. Once you start renting Chocobos and catching them, Cloud enters through here. A little weird. And one more stable left, which unfortunately means I'm going to have to let a Chocobo go when I have to make a gold one. Wait a second. Sorry, I'm a little discombobulated. Let me, just one more time check. Okay, yeah. KFC is male. KFC. Alright, give me a wonderful female, please. Yeah, look at that. Look at that sprint. Better than.
Please be a.
Yay! Ah! Happy day!
Do 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 do. Someone. Name it Derpabo, name it Ted.
Wait, Derpabo? I can't fit Derpabo. Unfortunately.
Gotta go fast. Name it Patch.
Nah, I see.
Aw, no Patch. You could name it Tadoof.
No, not Tadoof. That's a Pokemon. That's stupid.
You're stupid.
Alright, I have to. I gotta get more Silka screens. I gotta feed this thing before we begin race. Yeah, by the way, folks, like we're not even at the racing part of this fucking session yet. And we got a lot of racing to do. Because we gotta get that black Chocobo up to A rank, and we gotta get that wonderful Chocobo up to S rank, if I remember correctly.
Yeah. And then after you already name it, somebody says, name it Emily.
Well, we still got to give the gold Chocobo a name. Let me see. This is going to be the last Chocobo I feed, because I'm not going to bother feeding or racing with the gold Chocobo. You know what? 20. Why not?
So Ted's getting fucked by KFC, huh?
Son of a bitch. They're conspiring, I tell you.
The fanfics write themselves.
And one day I say I don't like their bone this week, and suddenly I'm getting fucked! At least I get to listen to the high wind theme a lot. Oh, one little thing you can do, when you take your Chocobo out to ride, you can board it in the high wind. You know, in case it's really redundant with the gold Chocobo's case, I suppose. But, you know, you can take it inside the high wind, then you can go inside the high wind and go inside the little Chocobo stable and see how your Chocobo's doing. It's a little cute.
It's so adorable.
No.
Ted goes to Taco Bell. No, Nathan goes to Taco Bell and comes back with 30 tacos.
Fuck yeah.
God. The random things my family makes me do when I come back from... Wait. Explain this story? I have a family to feed.
They're getting along better. Who's ready to race? Anybody?
Hey John.
Anybody?
What's your fastest speed run of Symphony of the Night?
Fastest speed run of Symphony of the Night? Yes. I don't have an active time, if that's what you're getting at. Like, I speed run Super Metroid more than Symphony of the Night because Symphony of the Night has so many other variables compared to Super Metroid, like shield dashing and all that other shit. But I would say. Not caring about room completion in percentages, just so I can get the normal ending, I would say less than 3 hours.
Also, somebody asks, what's our favorite mini game? No specifics, it just said favorite
minigame.
I'm gonna say Running of the Bulb from Mario Party 1.
If we're going Mario Party.
That's always been one of my favorite minigames.
Yeah, I like Domination from Mario Party 4. If only because I like button mashing. I'm pretty good at it.
Button mashing. Oh, my little sister's friend has this, I don't know how she does it, but she has this weird thing where her thumb doesn't move. Well, it looks like it's not moving, but she's vibrating her thumb so quick that she can press the button probably about 70 times.
But it's like a blur?
Yeah. Like, you don't see her thumb's not moving. And afterwards, she has to let her hand cool off.
Rare foil, what specific version of Adobe Premiere do I use? I use CS5. I've had that since 2011. I bought it when I had a student discount, and I took advantage of that shit before I graduated. The most recent one is CS6, I think. And
CS6 and also Creative Cloud 2014.
Yeah, what Nathan said.
I have, because I'm a student in college right now, I get a discount on the Creative Cloud, and I have the Creative Cloud versions of a shitload of programs I have to use.
Fucking son of a bitch. Now, I don't know. I'm not sure how you pay for, like, the Creative Suite nowadays. I hear, like, you have to, like, get, like, a monthly plan. Like, you gotta finance it now because it's expensive.
Well, for the Creative Cloud, it's a monthly fee.
Yeah. And, ugh. I'd rather just buy it in bulk, honestly, but that's a lot of money, dude.
Yeah.
All right, so Chocobo Racing. We've done this once before, and but now we can, like, race our own Chocobos.
And Marche or March 8? No, her friend has beaten Turbo Controllers.
Like, damn.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
So, we get the choice between two courses. There's the long course and the short one. It does not matter what course you pick. You have to race three times and win three times to advance a rank. I used to think that, you know, doing the long courses would be faster than just doing the short courses. But the only difference between the two, besides length, is the items you can win. Like, you can get better items by racing in the long course. But for the sake of moving on, folks, like, I'm going to do a majority of short. I'll show off long once, but it's going to be primarily short courses.
Somebody wants to know who our first YouTubers were.
YouTubers? Mine was James Rolfe. James Rolfe and Little Karibo, actually. Yu-Gi-Oh! Bridged.
Mine was a cosplay group by the name of JAC Productions.
Yeah.
They did a skit called The Village of DDR. It was a crossover of Dance Dance Revolution, Kingdom Hearts, and Naruto.
All right, who's ready to go to Taco Bell?
Okay.
Here's how this works. You know, we gotta come in first place, of course. And with this top speed and stamina, that's gonna be very easy to do. The items we can win are down here, depending on who comes in second place is what we're gonna get. So hopefully we can go for that Phoenix down and exchange it for a lot of GP. Well, not a lot of GP, but, you know, a nice number. When you're ready to go... Where the hell is my... Okay, there it is. Wait a minute. Something's not right here. Sorry, folks. Gotta reset the buttons here for a second because something's not working right. Where is my assist button? Switch is on 3.
Taco Bell abuse kills your stomach and intestines.
Hmm.
But it's so good.
Does anybody remember the button combination in Chocobo Racing on the PC version? I know it's page down and another button. I know I gotta be holding down another button. It's page down and something else. Because I know that the speed up button is assist. You know, I know. If this is the PlayStation 1 version, I wouldn't have me to do all this because I know those buttons by heart. But, shit, because you have to hold down two buttons in order to keep your stamina increasing so that you can run as fast as you want. Matt, I have Metal Chocobo on standby if Joe shows up. Anybody knows who I'm talking about? I hate Joe.
He's an asshole.
Let me see. No, I'm looking it up because I don't want to waste too much time here. You know.
Well, someone said up, down, left, right, A, B, start, and then someone said up.
Konami code.
That's not even the Konami code. Up, down, left.
That's right, I turned off the video feed for a second, folks.
What are your thoughts on Sonic Runners for mobile devices? I don't have a thought.
That was a new window. Here's open a new window. There you go.
Will SGB be getting to Luigi U?
At some point or another. One second. I'm sorry. Like I suck at answering shit while I'm multitasking. I'm sorry, guys. My button setup changed while I switched between my laptop and my PC. So I have to reset one of the buttons, but I don't remember which button it was to keep the stamina raising.
Worst animated show or shows you've ever seen?
Worst animated show? You know, I can't really think of one off the top of my head immediately without doing some like critical thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Because yeah, that's, you know, I've watched a lot of cartoons growing up.
Yeah, I'm the same way right now. No, I can't think of anyone that right off the top. What's my favorite handheld? My favorite handheld is my 3DS. Nathan, favorite robot master of the Mega Man series. If we're talking entirely favorite robot master, God.
Okay, according to this, it's page down and target keys.
Page down and target?
Yeah, page down is pretty much the equivalent of R1 for me on the button. And target, what do I have target set to?
Someone asked what are our thoughts on the pictures revealed for Five Nights at Freddy's 3, and Ryan says for worst animated show was the Donkey Kong Country show.
And I barely watched that.
It was so bad it was good for me. And then someone wants to know our favorite Pokemon.
Raichu. I can't say that enough times.
Right, I can't say Ampharos enough.
Yeah. Okay, I think we're good to go.
Damn, right. I'm still stuck on favorite robot master. In terms of what though? Because like, I have favorite robot masters in terms of design, and.
Well, one little detail that I love here. I'm sorry to cut you off for a second, Nathan, but you know, like when Final Fantasy VII loads FMVs from an area, you know, the pre-rendered area is technically not there anymore, and it's not any more obvious than when this guy right here, like his feet suddenly pop in when I go inside the gondola. Like, look at it, yeah. It's like, oh, my newspaper stand is not here anymore.
Will you continue to bother with Amiibo?
I don't know. If I can get some benefit out of it, why not? I don't plan on getting the whole set, if that's what you mean.
John and Nathan, what are the weirdest games you've ever played?
I'm not even sure if I can make a top 10.
The weirdest game I've ever played is also one of the most fun games I've ever played. I only know it as the table flipping game.
The table flipping game?
It was an arcade game in Japan.
Really?
Yes. The whole point was you startle an entire room by slapping your hands on this table, and then when you're ready, you flip the table up and you just cause mass mayhem. It's awesome!
John Nathan, favorite Metal Gear Solid games?
Well, I'm actually getting a marathon ready to go for that soon, so I'm just going to have to wait on that. Sorry for copying out.
I've only ever played one. I never really got into the Metal Gear Solid series, mainly because I never had the systems.
Well, you can get them, like, many ways now.
Well, I know I can get them many ways now, but I never got around to getting them. Somebody said Akihabara Strip. Whoever said that, I love you. Akihabara is my favorite city in the entire world. It's like a paradise for us, John. It's nothing but video games and anime all over.
Brosif 2015 says, God, KFC is fast. That's a first. I agree. Now, here's the real bad thing about, like, Chocobo racing in the beginning, folks. Since your Chocobo is so maxed out in stats, you're, like, you're trailblazing. You know, you're so super fast, and your opponents are super slow. So when you win the race, you have to wait for your opponents to catch up. And you can't exit. You gotta wait to at least someone comes in second place. And then you can just press start to exit everything. But in the meantime, you have to wait. And this is just the beginning, folks, because in order to, we have to do a total of 9 races with the black Chocobo to get him to A rank. Mm-hmm. 12 for the other Chocobo to get to S rank. And we're for our spoils of war, we got a Turbo Ether, which I believe is worth, I think, 100 GP. Or at least 50. You can, when you win an item, you can either take the item or you can get GP. I recommend getting GP. Yeah, 150 GP, not bad. I think the highest GP winning you can earn is from a Mega Elixir, which is 300. But we're just beginning, folks! Remember, I'll put on a crazy Chocobo if Joe shows up. But let me show off a long course once. Is there anyone else besides Joe that's known for being a dickhead?
John Nathan, least favorite Halloween movie?
Probably 6. Well, Curse of Michael Myers. It doesn't have a number. Look at this asshole burning himself out so early.
Yeah. And then someone asked me what my bearded dragon's name is. The bearded dragon belonged to Emily, guys, and his name is Reptar.
The king of dinosaurs. Hey, you gotta burn yourself out. Yeah, you son of a bitch. Yeah, that's how a lot of races begin, either in the short or long curse. It's always gonna be that one asshole that decides he wants to hold down the speed up, well, the sprint button, for as long as he possibly can, and then he burns out around the spiral staircase.
Well, gotta go fast.
Yeah, of course. It's Chocobo racing. What the fuck? I'm just doing my job. Yeah, but you're also burning out like 10 seconds into the race.
John Nathan, favorite Mario RPG?
Probably 6. Yeah, Chocobo courses have
RPG,
different...
RPG, John.
RPG?
Yes.
That's the Final Fantasy 6.
No, Mario RPG.
Oh, Mario RPG. I didn't hear Mario. Paper Mario 1000 Year Door.
Yeah. That's a no-brainer. I haven't really dabbled too much into the Mario and Luigi games.
Yeah.
I played the first one, and I dabbled in a little bit of Partners in Time. That's it.
Hey, by the way, folks, in the PC version, this rapid water sound effect doesn't go away. So, it sounds like we're coming in live in a hurricane. Nice scenery, regardless. This is where the Chocobos begin to sprint. The short and long courses also have a bit of obstacles in the form of terrain. Like, the long course, we went through a section of, like, we were underwater for a split second. Regular Chocobos and a green Chocobo slow down in that area. But if you're riding a blue Chocobo or a black Chocobo or a gold Chocobo, they're not affected by that terrain. In the short course, at the very end of the race, there is a space-like section. Green Chocobos are not affected by that, as are black chocobos and gold chocobos, but regular chocobos and blue chocobos they slow down when they're in that area. So that's generally when they want you to hold the sprint button down to get past that area as fast as you possibly can. And I won a hyper. I think it's worth 5 GP.
Nathan, why is your closet a dishwasher? People, stop confusing me for Donnie.
Yeah, that's Donnie that broadcast in his closet.
Dishwasher.
Sorry. The dishwasher in the closet.
Yes.
We talked about this.
Nathan, are you excited for the new Star Fox? Yes.
We think we're going to get a trailer for that E3 or sometime earlier.
Probably E3.
I would probably say sometime earlier, since they plan on releasing it before Zelda Wii U.
John, will you play Mystical Ninja starring Goemon, or at least look at it?
I know of it. So that's a maybe. Hey, wait, I'm trying to switch to Mano, damn it.
I heavily encourage it, John. I heavily encourage looking at Legend of the Mystical Ninja.
Yeah, I've heard how charming it is. Oh, my Chocobo's really booking it for this session.
Gotta go fast.
Yeah, no, Legend of the Mystical Ninja was probably one of the weirder Super Nintendo games I've played, but I love it to death.
Yeah, my Chocobo's going really fucking fast this time. Holy shit. God damn, go!
I did it!
Is there a turbo boost in the beginning that I could do with a Chocobo? Because that was really fucking fast. I've seen that happen before, but I never really questioned it until now because it was so obvious here.
What is your favorite working designs game?
I don't remember who that developer is. Nathan, I'm pretty sure I know of the game, but...
Oh, they're talking about the N64 version of Mystical Ninja. Well, I still suggest the Super Nintendo one.
That's the one I know.
See, people? Someone's asking if a gold chocobo can go underwater.
Yeah, no, not underwater. I'm pretty sure if you stay still, it'll drown at some point.
It'll be like the submarine, it'll just go down.
Megalixir? 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 Oh, hyper. Oh, the little dance that Cloud does. He's really fucking excited for winning that.
Are you sure he just doesn't have freaking rider's crotch from bouncing on a chocobo?
My underwear aren't there anymore. Do you want to guess where? All right, we're in the B rank. 3 more races, then it's in the A rank, and then we can switch over to Ted.
Hey, John, are you planning to get the new 3DS Majora's Mask Edition?
Yeah, of course. I already got it pre-ordered. Look at this punk bitch. Wait, you go you keep dashing. You're gonna burn yourself out around here. Yeah, look at that. Bye.
Johnny is gonna ride Ted soon.
Oh my god.
No, Johnny is not riding him.
Yeah, Cloud is. Hey, get it right.
Someone said rename the Chocobo Usain Bolt. Nathan, what's your favorite thing at Taco Bell? Crunch wraps.
Maybe I've had them? It used to be the double-decker taco for me. I think it still is. I just haven't had Taco Bell in a long time.
Tacos. Tacos are awesome.
Yeah. Megalixir? Megalixir? Fire Fang!
So how about that meteor?
What? Oh, right! Cloud, you dolt!
Johnny, Nathan, have you ever been to a foreign country?
No, I have not.
I've lived in Japan and Korea.
Excuse me!
I'm sorry, okay, I got stationed in Japan and deployed to Korea. I'm sorry, I had to go do cop stuff. grenade launchers.
Hey, see, I could sprint to you, motherfuckers.
Nathan, John,
but I know when to let go of the button.
Do you two think the next main series Sonic game will be this year? Will they hold it off for the 25th? What?
Oh, the next mainstream Sonic game.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't be surprised if there is not. It's not going to be a mainstream Sonic game for this year because next year is Sonic's 25th anniversary.
Don't remind me because I turned 25.
Oh, you poor thing.
Oh, shut up.
Oh, I never noticed that UFO. Or was it a jellyfish?
Oh God! And the chat just exploded.
What, with taco time?
No, with stuff about me being in the military. First off, I was in the Air Force. I lived in Japan for 2 years. I'm not in the Air Force any longer. I'm a full-time college student. I live at Disney World.
Disney World!
And when I was in Korea, I don't know if I had dog or not.
What?
Somebody asked if I've ever had dog. I don't know.
Like, the farthest I ever traveled out of the states was Puerto Rico, and that's barely beyond Florida.
Are you excited for Splatoon?
I'm looking forward to it. I'm gonna get it. I'm not sure if I'm gonna get it day one, but I'm gonna get it.
Yeah, I'm excited for it myself. Nathan, Johnny, what do you think of the Majora's Mask DLC pack for Hyrule Warriors? Haven't got it.
Well, I'm gonna get it. February 5th was the release date. So, yeah, I'm gonna get it. Why not? Oh, there he is! There he is! That's Joe! He's always gonna have a better top speed and stamina than you. He's like the boss of Chocobo Racing.
Well, we'll just have to be the bigger boss.
One second, folks. Alright, Nathan, this music's kind of going to drown our voices out, so I apologize.
No problem. I decided to type in the chat to let everyone know his concentration is through the roof. You didn't say a word the entire race.
Fuck, the song's bugged for itself.
That headbanging.
Oh, Turbo Ether. What an Omega Elixir.
Redo!
Yeah, that's Joe.
Asshole.
And of course, he'd be like the last thing I race in before KFC goes A rank. Alright, but KFC's at A rank. I wouldn't rate them that high, honestly, but you know, for this Chocobo, that's all we need. But now we have to race with Ted. And Ted needs to be at S rank.
Nathan, Johnny, how did you guys mirror? I think that's supposed to say meet.
Mirror?
We've been friends for almost 5 years now.
I would say that long, yeah.
Yeah, because of Sonic Paradox.
Yeah. But I don't remember exactly how we met, though.
When you first posted on Sonic Paradox, you posted your original Sonic interview.
Yeah.
And at that point, I was already a moderator of the forum. And once I watched your interview, I started watching your stuff more and more. And I remember somebody had said something along the lines of, the end of your first cast interview is the same as the parody, the abridged series they do called Sonic F. The ending was an acapella Green Hill Zone thing.
Oh, yeah.
And I was just like, yeah, but I'm pretty sure he had no idea that Sonic F was even a thing.
No. And I think I saw a question earlier whether or not I know of Sonic F. Yeah, I know of. I never really watched it, though. It's an abridged Sonic X, right?
Yeah, it's abridged Sonic X using all of the Sonic Paradox guys.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, glad you guys have a nice little project to keep yourselves busy. But, you know, I never had time to sit down and watch it.
And, yeah, I know. And then from watching your interview, I started watching your reviews, and then I started watching Brain Scratch. And then one thing led to another, and we started talking to each other. And then here we are.
Buster Legacy, but I'm guessing Buster Legacy says Ted just needs to be A rank, not S rank. Okay, we can do it that way if we want to. I always race the wonderful Chocobo to S rank. That's just the way I've been doing it for years. Then again, I'm also the kind of player back in a long time ago I used to feed my Chocobo 99 silk screens.
Johnny, are you going to play Disgaea?
That's Matt asking that.
Yeah. Well, somebody keeps asking who's going to play it for the channel. I only keep catching every like half of the sentence, so I don't get the entire thing.
Yeah, but and we're sorry about this. Like, there's only so much we can do when there's a lot of people here, folks. 554 according to the counter on XSplit. I don't have the page loaded, but yeah, I'm glad you guys can make it, and I'm sorry.
Nathan, are you wearing your Mega Man hat? Yes, it's engraved into my skull.
You sleep with your Buster on.
You don't know that?
Well, coach! I mean, no, I don't.
What are you talking about? I don't... Stay back!
Switch, damn it. There you go. Yeah, it's best to just have your Chocobo on manual operation so that you can speed up and slow down when you need to. Though I've never slowed down ever in a Chocobo race. Ever. Never found the need to. And I've had too many times where in automatic operation, my Chocobo acted like a damn dumbass. You know, burning out energy that he clearly doesn't have. Making lousy bets. Counting cards. He just makes a lot of bad life choices, folks.
John and Nathan, what's your game of the year, not including Smash?
Well, for last year?
Yeah.
I would say Bayonetta 2. I had a lot of fun with that one.
I'm gonna go to Lords of Shadows 2.
Lords of Shadow 2, really?
Yeah. I had a lot of fun with Lords of Shadows 2. Nathan, did you figure out what your favorite Robot Master is?
Anyway, I realized I didn't really answer the question a few minutes ago, but the Disgaea question. I never played Disgaea, ever. Elliot has, but I've never played Disgaea. Heard of it, heard it's great, but never had any interest. But, you know, all that can change, you never know. Expanding my horizontals.
Damn, this is...
Oh, Blaze Henry says, we'll be playing the crazy Chocobo theme in DMC 3. It's the same singer. Oh, I didn't know that.
Hmm.
We got a tranquilizer? What are you trying to say, Esther?
You need to slow down.
Cloud, I don't know how to tell you this, but you've been up for 86 hours. Say what?
Is Elliot doing Mother 3?
No.
Hey, Nathan, when is Sonic Paradox's next video? We're actually at a standstill right now. No, we don't have enough animators.
Oh, because everyone... Well, everyone's finding their own things to do, and...
Yeah, well, a lot of the old animators are now actually, like me, are in college.
Yeah.
I mean, we all started doing that stuff back in high school, and we actually had all the free time in the world.
Yeah.
But now a lot of us are in college.
Yeah, that's like another reason why it was, compared to like 2010 for me, like why it was easier for me to make cartoons, because I was unemployed back then. I didn't have a job, and I was getting unemployment checks, but I had a lot of fucking free time. And nowadays, it is something I really do need to work on. Like, I am very glad of the amount of subscribers that I have for Somecallmejohnny and the like, but, you know, I did go to school for that sort of thing, folks. You know, I got a bachelor's degree just sitting in the closet collecting dust. And I wanted to put it to use. The problem is that making cartoons takes a long time, folks. Especially if it's over a minute. Like, for me, that can take 3 weeks. And I have to, like, do nothing but work on that cartoon. Like, I'm trying to work on multitasking. I really am. But you can't ask me to multitask while working on an animation. I need to be focused on that and nothing but that. So if I were to work on a cartoon... Like, Somecallmejohnny will be devoid of anything for, like, 3 or 4 weeks. And, you know, that's not very, you know, that's not exactly recommended to do.
John and Nathan, what are your opinion of Death Battle?
Screw Attack Death Battle?
Yeah.
I'm guessing. I watch when I catch it. I don't actively hunt for it, but I like what I see.
There are times when I get bored and I'm just like, I want to watch a death battle, and then I find out there's a new one. And I was just like,
yeah. I've never watched that.
Nathan, favorite robot master weapon? Quick boomerang. I just like the quick boomerang for its power. Nathan, what is your favorite brain scratch moment?
Well, there's this guy named Nathan who recorded DKC3.
Actually, no. My favorite moment that included me has to be the part of Mega Man X3 where I outpunned Ted.
What was that again?
Ted kept making horrible puns, and there was a point where you were climbing up a spiky wall, and Ryan's just like sharp and pointy, and Ted's like, I don't see how spikes don't do as much damage as lasers. And I, under my breath, said, Ted's not getting the point.
Oh. Yeah, I tend to burn those memories away.
I remember you straight up told everybody to shut the fuck up, and you're like, Nathan, say that again. I have my moments where I can make people just laugh. Did you love Japanese food as much as I did when I lived in Okinawa for 3 years? I love Japanese food to this day. It is my favorite food ever.
What are we talking about here? Like,
someone asked me if I like Japanese.
No. Food. I'm asking what kind of cuisine. You know.
Let's see. There's gyudon beef bowl, which is basically rice and flavored shredded beef, and you can get cheese on it, and it's really freaking addicting. There's all the different types of sushi. There's tempura, there's authentic miso soup. Yeah. John Nathan, what is your favorite DK Donkey Kong Country game, including Returns and Tropical Freeze? I haven't played Tropical Freeze yet.
It's a good game. Like, I'd recommend Tropical Freeze. I haven't beaten it yet, but it's, from what I've played, it's a contender for best DKC game.
I can't I normally don't play through the beginning of a Donkey... I don't play a Donkey Kong Country game without Emily. We have certain things where me and Emily have to play games together, and Donkey Kong Country is one of them. Like, when I first got Donkey Kong Country Returns, me and Emily stayed up till the day before I got shipped out to boot camp to beat Donkey Kong Country Returns. Yeah,
that's all fine and all, you know. You got someone to play with, get great memories together. Those end up being the best memories, honestly.
Yeah, that's kind of why, like, me and Emily have such a great relationship with each other, is because of all the video games we played when we were younger.
Yeah, it's similar. It's pretty similar. I would say even the exact same with me and Elliot. And Mark to an extent, but you know, Mark does his own thing. So.
Yeah. How much of the donations have you played so far?
I'll get back to you on that.
Ted getting pounded by Cloud. Rest in peace, Ted. Oh, God. John, would you ever consider doing subscriptions for your channel and designing emotes for it as well?
Like Twitch subscriptions?
Yeah.
I don't stream that often to get real, you know, don't waste your money, folks. You know, I want to do more live streams, yeah, but, you know, a follow is enough.
John Nathan, what's the scariest thing you've seen in a video game?
You know, Fatal Frame, I would say, is right up there with a scariest experience. But, you gotta, set the mood for Fatal Frame, folks. Like, I'm talking dark room, nothing but the TV on, and surround sound set to max! We singing Lollipop? What the fuck was that?
No, I was thinking, because
this Lollipop is delicious.
I don't know. When it comes to scary games, I never really found anything too off the charts for scary.
Besides, typical jump scares, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because the jump scares aren't really scary, they're shocking.
Yeah.
You know? The Fatal Frame terrified me. But that was over 10 years ago too, though, you know?
No, you know what? The first time I ever got to the last level of Echo the Dolphin, that scared the shit out of me. Nothing is too spooky for Nathan. No, I wish I didn't have to restart my laptop and I accidentally lost a lot of video footage. If you would have seen the stream I did when I streamed I'm Scared at night in the fucking morning, I almost pissed my pants.
Damn.
And the thing is it's all 8-bit graphics.
I think this is the last race for Ted.
You can do it, Ted. You're not the weakest link. Will SGB do Five Nights at Freddy's 2?
Stay tuned.
Nathan Senpai, how can I learn to grow a beard like yours? Oh, Zappin' Rat. Oh. Honestly, I don't know, because mine's not that great. I just kind of let it get unruly, and then I trim it down. Nathan, do you play any trading card games? I used to play Yu-Gi-Oh! And I used to play Magic. And back when it was sort of a thing, I used to play Duel Masters.
I never found the appeal of Duel Masters. It was always, to me, it was always... And I don't mean to sound, bitter towards it, but... It just, a cheap knockoff of a trading card game that was just trying to ride Yu-Gi-Oh!'s coattails.
Yeah, that's essentially what it was. Nathan, you got a fist in that beard? No, I'm a black belt in Taekwondo. I had another foot. Hit roundhouse kicks, people, when I get upset.
really awkward where my sister accidentally ticks me off. But she's learned to dodge.
Oh no, because when it comes down to it, I fear my sister. Like
she counters the foot.
My sister's a higher rank than me in Taekwondo. She's a second degree black belt. I'm only a first degree. John, do you play Echo the Dolphin? You don't play Echo the Dolphin.
Shut up. Keep saying it might happen. It's like Candyman. Say it 3 times in front of a mirror. You know, I mean, in this case, like, I say Echo the Dolphin 3 times in a mirror, and a fucking real-life dolphin pops out of the mirror. It doesn't do anything, and it just looks at me, and it goes back inside the mirror.
The Peter, WTF. Actually, no, I don't fear my sister. I'm not, like, I fear my sister when it comes to, like, us having to go against each other, but it's not like I fear her. And I used to do Muay Thai kickboxing, too.
Brosa 2015 says, I live Echo the Dolphin.
Is Emily your sister? Yes.
What? Are you Nathan?
Z-Ego 094. Gex?
What about it?
I'm kind of interested because I love Gex. Gex was awesome. Keyword was. I don't know. I have to buy them on PSN again, so I can. Well, I have to buy them on PSN so I can relive the. See if they hold up.
Let me see here. Since we did just make the Black Chocobo, KFC. I'm saying, I was definitely holding the acceleration button. I did not mean to land immediately after. My high wind just essentially jumped.
John and Nathan, what would you press X to do?
Rich.
360 no scope for all the Wii flashlight selfie.
There you go. I like to press X to rich, please. I got these annoying ass college bills that need to be paid.
Ha! I mean, sorry. I'm a dick like that. Thoughts on Banjo-Kazooie and Tooie?
Let me see here. I'm going to try and mate now. If the Black Chocobo is still too young, then I have to go outside and do some random battles.
Hey, Johnny, do you love waffles?
Oh, wait. I gotta release a Chocobo first. Oh, damn, this is...
Release the Kraken!
I gotta release a Chocobo. It's gonna be one of the two yellow ones, of course. I'm not getting rid of my color ones. Choka or Choka? You know what? Choco. It's been fun, but...
Johnny's X button equals Elliot, seriously.
I have to let you go, Choco. I'm sorry. Toodaloo. Then he gets eaten by the Midgar Zolom. Oh my god. Let me see if I can... Which two Chocobos are you going to mate?
This one and that one. And maybe it's that one.
Alright, KFC and Ted shall mate. Finger looking good.
Johnny and Nathan, have you guys played Meme Run? No, and I don't plan on it.
I can't believe something like that actually got, like, approved.
I've actually seen the game in action from a YouTuber that actually lives not too far from me, and it's horrible. It's, like, it's everything you'd expect from a game called Meme Run.
Oh, the achievement just spoiled that I got the Gold Chocobo before the Gold Chocobo even appeared.
Hey, John, I think you got the Gold Chocobo.
Yay, I got it. Thanks, achievement. What the hell?
Wark.
What the hell? That's not very fun. Like, my suspense was shot to shit.
Thank you. do you name it?
I don't know. A gold chocobo. Male at that.
So it looks like somebody smashed their head on the keyboard. It was like, aqua. And how do you spell that exactly? Name it Bork. Blitz.
See, Goldie. I can't fit Goldilocks.
Corey.
I'm seeing Goku spoiled with a D.
Name it Elliot.
Spooge.
Hardy.
Killzone.
Boko Vegeta.
That says Bobby's kind of generic. There you go. I like that. Dumas. I love that name.
Lunk, please. Lunk.
Huzzah! We did it! A gold chocobo! Let's take it out.
John Nathan, what was the best Halloween costume you ever wore?
Sub-Zero dressed for the winter.
You guys really have to ask that? Look at Johnny's Mega Man 7 review. Just replace Clyde with Blinky. Or Inky. And have Inky, Blinky, Pinky, and Clyde running away from Pac-Man in Tokyo.
The majestic Dumas.
That's dumbass.
No. Am I your man, Mr. Dumbass? Look at it in all of its washed-out glory. Folks, the gold chocobo in the PS1 version looks a hell of a lot more majestic. You know, the legs especially really pop. You know? But yes, this is a gold chocobo. Giddy up!
Ring Mega Man Legends 2 and Mega Man ZX Advent have the biggest offenders of cliffhangers in history. I agree with the Mega Man ZX Advent. That shit pissed me off.
KRSG said I should have named it Midas. Yeah, that's pretty clever.
If you both had the ability to turn into a badass monster, what monster would you want to turn into?
I don't know. Like, I honestly can't answer that. A lot of monsters out there. A lot of interesting ones. Anyway. Gold Chocobo. It can go anywhere. Anywhere.
Do anything.
Yeah. It can play the bongos if you ask nicely. It even knows how to do 3-card truffle shuffle.
I just expect, like, a set of arms to come out from under its wings and do all these things.
It could play. It could box.
Whoa!
It even knows how to play Magic the Gathering.
Now watch as it DDRs.
Max 300 and heavy. But this is the real reason why you're going after. Now you can get this chocobo. Well, this materia, this special item here with the different colored chocobos. Like this one right here. I think you just need a. I think just. Do we cross water? See, if so, then we need at least the River Chocobo for this one. Over the course of many years, Mako energy crystallizes into materia. This is the Quadra Magic Materia. It's almost exactly what it sounds like. Any materia that's linked to it, you will cast 4 times in a row. So, like, that's 4 magic castings in one turn. And that also, I think that also applies to summoning. I think you need to have the proper amount of stars, though, for that to work. Like, if you want to, like, quadra cast Bahamut Zero 4 times, I think Bahamut Zero needs to be at least 4 stars. I think I'm remembering that right. Anyway, that's one. There are 4 special items we can get with our special chocobo. And I believe the other one is close by.
Work.
To Wutai!
Four Knights of the Round does not work with Quadra Magic. No, it does not.
No, it does not. You can use W summon with Knights of the Round, but not Quadra Magic.
you'd be watching the cinematic for ever.
I need grass to land on.
To Wu Tang.
Now this little area always fumbled me up. I never remembered the exact area. I think it was around here. Anyway, we got a gold chocobo. We can go anywhere. We're going to find it eventually. Oh, here it is. That didn't take very long.
Found it.
Man, it's a good thing these chocobos are so obedient. I'd be fucked if it dished me while I was here. Because my airship can't land here. Over the course of many years, Mako energy will crystallize into materia. Mime! Oh boy. We just won the game. We just won the game, folks. Mime, again, like Quadra Magic, exactly what it sounds like. When you have it equipped, you get the Mime command. Mime allows you to mimic the last thing someone did before you, except for Limit Breaks, obviously. But, you know, in the case of, like, a Cloud, if he... You got Omni Slash level 4 Limit Break, you know, you do it, then you choose Mime again after that. If Cloud has Mime Materia equipped, you can do Omni Slash right after that. I mean, it's disgusting, the possibilities you can do with Mime. Alright, I recall the next one is close to Mount Corel. So, let's go there.
Oh yeah, the meteor.
Oh, right! Oh shit! I completely forgot! When's it landing? Tomorrow? Hey, what's your opinion on FPSs, Nathan? Oh, rare foil ass. I'll say, you know, I don't have a stigma against FPSs. If it's good, it's good. If it's bad, you know, whatever. You know, I live to play another day.
I have nothing against FPSs. I grew up playing Halo with my older brother, Mark. We beat every Halo together on Legendary mode together. I mean, I love playing Halo. I'll play Call of Duty. I'll play Battlefield, but it's just, they're not my go-to games.
All right, now for what many consider to be the grand prize.
Work. I'm working on water.
I'm working on water. Whoa! You need to go Chocobo in order to get to this isolated island that's not on your map at all. You can't land here, of course, because there's nothing but dense forest in the region. But this is it. Oh, it's red. It's a summon materia. I like the materia here that you pick up are triangle-shaped, like isosceles.
Oh, come on. Don't do that to me.
Knights of the Round. The most powerful summon in the game. Costs a whopping 250 MP, if I remember that off the top of my head correctly. But, shall we demonstrate? To end this session of Final Fantasy, 7, Session 14. Who shall cast it? I'll have Cloud cast it, why not?
Cloud.
I'm not gonna need the Chocobo lore anymore. And damn it, does it take for fucking ever to master. You saw that correctly. Just to level up once, you need 50,000 AP. And we haven't, reached the best grinding spot yet for AP growth. That's in the Northern Crater. That's endgame. Magic pots and movers and shit. But, alright, who's gonna be... Oh boy, you guys picked the wrong people to fuck with. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, this is Knights of the Round.
Here, have a movie.
Super Sam, the Ham Twitch, first Final Fantasy game I would recommend is probably 4. I think that one's very beginner-friendly without being too simple for its own good.
Are you looking forward to Yoshi's Woolly World? Yes.
Yeah, I'm gonna get it. It looks much better than New Yoshi's Island. Like, that game legitimately angers me.
I'm sorry, John. I'm sorry that Yoshi's New Island angers you. It... Nathan, how many legendary Pokemon do you have in Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire? A big hole, whopping none. I don't have the game. Are they dead yet? Are they dead yet? He didn't even hit them! How did he hit them?
He sliced in between them! Shenanigan! This is fake! Yowzers! That is Knights of the Round, ladies and gentlemen. The maximum damage I think it can do, assuming all hits do 9999, is 250,000 HP. Like, that's more than any boss in the game, not counting super bosses and the maxed out Safer Sephiroth. It is positively, disgustingly overpowered. It is ridiculous.
Yes.
I mean, holy shit. Now, how do I get back home? My gold chocobo is sleeping. Well, I guess we're camping out here for the night.
Have you played the Battle Network series?
No, I've not.
I've played 3 and 4 Blue Moon. I've played both versions of 3, and I've played...
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. Someone's actually doing the fucking math. I appreciate that, guys. 9999 times 13 equals 129,987. Thank you. That's the max you can do with Knights of the Round.
Was it worth the work, Johnny?
Yes, it was worth the work. It was... Fuck you, okay? I just caught that.
Somebody actually asked that in chat. Super Luigi 88.
Was it worth the work?
Johnny, Nathan, do you know what happens to a toad when it's struck by lightning? No, do I want to know?
That's an X-Men quote. The same thing that happens to everything else. That's such a stupid fucking line. I think I was expecting a badass answer. You know what happens to a toad when it gets struck by lightning? It actually gets super fucking smart.
Like, my mindset is not in, like, thinking X-Men right now. I was thinking, what the fuck is wrong with this person?
That's a good chocobo. Fuck you, okay? That's a fantastic chocobo! It took me 3 hours to raise!
Yeah.
John, Nathan, favorite game composer?
I would say Nobuo Uematsu. I can always go back and rely on that man or deliver the goods. Ladies and gentlemen, that's it. That is it for... Session Chocobo of Final Fantasy VII Live. You got something to say, Nathan, before we close off?
Yeah, I was going to say my favorite composer is Koji Kondo.
Oh, okay.
Also, yes, I do watch Vine Sauce Baba Goose Goodies.
That's with Spallone Baba Goose Goodies.
Spallone Baba Goose Goodies. Goodies.
Yeah.
Oh.
I feel like a million bucks.
I feel a million bucks. Bird.
I feel a million bucks. You know, I could probably go inside that northern crater if I wanted to. Nah, that barrier kind of sneered at me.
I can go everywhere!
I can see everything! The music!
Wait, but the gold chocobo needs to drink the live stream.
Oh, that's right. We should probably head to Medeal. Hey, I mean, it's out in the open. We can do that.
Work.
I'm going the wrong fucking way.
Suddenly, Emerald Weapon just jumps out of the water and it just dies of fear of the.
No, this chocobo is newly born. You know, we didn't even get a chance to rest. Kyle, we didn't even cut the umbilical cord yet! Come back!
It's dragging the other chocobo.
It's dragging KFC. Work.
Wait, wasn't KFC the male? It's dragging Ted!
There we go. Drink up, buddy. You can take it. Anyway, folks, that is it for Session 14 of Final Fantasy VII Live. In the beginning of the next session, we're going to be doing a few more little odds and ends here and there, and then we're going to advance with plot by delivering the key to the agents to Bugenhagen, who's over at the Lost City waiting, wondering what the fuck is the holdup? There's a meteor coming down here! You know, we're going to go back to Bone Village, we're going to dig up a key to Sector 5 to get Tifa's premium heart. Let me see, what else can I do at this point in time? I already did the Wutai side quest. Adil's all good and dandy like cotton candy. Ultima Weapon is not flying around the world yet. Yeah, I think we're just going to go to the Bone Village, get the key card to Sector 5 so we can revisit Midgar. Yeah, we can go to the Ancient Forest. That's true. Now we have the Gold Chocobo. We don't have to wait to destroy Ultimate Weapon to gain access to it. You know what? Let me ride to that area right now to show where I'm at. I'm not going to go in there now, of course. You know what? We'll do that. We're going to get the key card of Sector 5, and then we're going to go to the Ancient Forest. And then we're going to proceed with plot, because the Ancient Forest is not going to take very long. Oh, I love this theme.
Yay. I win, go fast.
Let me see. So we got the Quadra Magic, we got Mime, we got the HP-MP Swap. I didn't talk about that one. HP-MP Swap swaps your MP with your HP. If you ever wanted 9,999 MP, but only 999 HP, well, this materia is for you. I don't use it, because I don't like only having, you know, Jesus Christ, if I'm going to be using magic a lot, I already have another materia combination, which pays for itself.
Mm-hmm.
And that, it's, you know, whatever. I've never, maybe for like a challenge run, but then again, you have to like wait till end game in order to get the MP HP swap materia. Unless you hack it in, of course. Where is this fucking place? Yeah, I'm heading towards Gunagaga now.
It's that way.
It's that way. Oh, I'll take your word for it, good sir.
You just go that way, and then you go the other way, and then you turn left, and then you turn.
Here it is. Yeah, I'm just gonna get off here. Because I can. I got a gold chicken.
But there ain't no getting off of this train.
Well, too bad, I just did. Here it is. This is the Ancient Forest. Without a gold chocobo or a mountain chocobo, you can get here with a green chocobo. You have to wait to destroy Ultimate Weapon. Because the last spot you fight him is over here. And when you kill him, he crash lands into this place, causing a huge crater, which opens up the way to the Ancient Forest. So, for Session 15 of Final Fantasy VII, we're going to get the key to Sector 5, you know, get that stuff. We're going to go to the Ancient Forest and get the apocalypse for Cloud, among other things. And then we're going to go to plot and open up the way to the northern crater. With all that said, folks, thank you again for joining me for session 14 of Final Fantasy VII Live. Nathan, as always, thank you for joining me, good sir, buddy old pal of mine.
Always a pleasure, John. Always a pleasure.
Yeah, and I'm going to go look up and see what I can do about performance power, because Final Fantasy VII does not run this slow, folks. I mean, it's bearable, but not... It could be a lot better. It may have something to do with how much shit I'm using at once. But thank you guys for watching. You have yourselves a fantastic night, and take care, please.
Manwich time.
Ooh.